Alright, welcome back to the channel. No, the title is not clickbait. I'm going to show you how to actually download Windows Enterprise for free directly from Microsoft using an official source. It's not tampered with. You don't have to worry that it's got some sort of malware bullshit. Now I'm going to show you three different ways that you can do this. Now the first one here, this tool used to work and I went to run it here recently and I saw there was some issues reported where people are saying that it doesn't work anymore. And I don't know what happened to the developer. He must have disappeared because the last version that was updated for was 21H2. And as of right now, Windows is 22H2. So I don't know if this guy's gonna come back to fix this. This was a really good tool. And it also worked well for people that didn't have the latest hardware that met the TPM requirements for Windows 11 because it actually had a bypass script built in to override TPM. And so here's the tool right here. When you start it up, you have all this stuff come up and it comes up with a window here where you can select the version of Windows that you want. You know, you can select Windows 10, 21H2. And then you'd get a choice to do one of these, or you could select what version that you wanted. And then when you picked this, it would come up with the media creation tool. The problem is I tried this and it wasn't working for me. So it would be nice if this guy would come back at some point and update the tool, because this was actually a really, really good option for just quickly getting Windows Enterprise. Second way is going to be through the Evaluation Center. Now, this one's really not the greatest option, but if you want to test drive Enterprise and load it up on like a virtual machine, you could certainly do that. These evaluation installs are good for 90 days. And so you can choose, I'll drop both links down in the description. By the way, I'll just drop links for everything down in the description, depending on what you want to use. Like I said, the media creation tool, unless this guy updates this, it's not working right now. Hopefully he'll update it so it'll be working again. The Evaluation Center, so you can pick these. So if you've never used Enterprise and you just want to give it a test run, you can come in and pick one of these and just like I said, install it like on a test a virtual machine or what have you. And if you haven't tried LTSC yet, I mentioned this a couple of times now. Those of you that have not tried LTSC, there are some downsides just because it's so stripped down, but this is really the way Windows should be. LTSC is really nice. Also drop the link down in the description if you want to get Windows 11 Enterprise and download that. Now what I'm going to show you is how to download the full Enterprise version directly from Microsoft. What you'll have to do is go to Microsoft's website to download the media creation tool. And so you can either pick Windows 10 or Windows 11. Now when you do the Enterprise, it's going to download either Windows 10 Enterprise or Windows 11, so pick whichever one you want. The executable file is named differently for between like Windows 10 and Windows 11. You'll come down here, pick Windows 11, or create Windows 11 installation media. So download this, it'll give you what's called the media creation tool. Then what you want to do, now what I did here is I just placed the media creation tool in the root C drive. Now, if you download it on like desktop or whatever, then obviously your file path is gonna go like C drive, users, whatever, desktop. Then what you do, so after this, so you've got your media creation tool. Now this is for Windows 11. If you're doing Windows 10 Enterprise, it's going to be, I believe it's like media creation tool 22H2 or something like that. Like I said, it's named differently between 10 and 11. Then what you do is you paste this. I'll drop this down in the description, paste this command. This is what's gonna download Enterprise instead of Windows 10 or Windows Home or Pro. One thing to just keep in mind, depending on the language that you use, like if you're in France, for example, it would be like FR-FR. So this is your language code. So whatever language, whatever country you're from, you'll just wanna change the language code to match whatever you need. Once you have all this typed in, click enter. Then media creation tool is going to pop up and it'll take just a moment for it to initialize stuff. Now this is when you know whether or not it actually worked. This, because when you do this, when you run Media Creation Tool normally, it won't ask you for a product key. When you try to run Windows Enterprise, it's going to ask you for the product key. And what I'm going to do is just paste that in. And I can already hear some of you saying right now,
"Oh, young man, you're in trouble. I'm gonna report you to Microsoft for piracy and they're gonna come spank your butt."
This key doesn't actually activate Windows. It just lets you install it. You can find these CD keys on their website. So I'll drop this link down below. That way you can pick whatever CD key you end up needing. In this case, I used the one for Enterprise, this one right here. They've got it right on their website for you to use. Now, after you do this, obviously it's gonna ask you, do you want to create USB drive or an ISO file? Anyway, so you go through the whole process, create your installation media, whatever you want to do. And just to show you that it works, this is using the ISO that you download from the Windows Creation Tool. So you can see this is running Windows Enterprise. I've got this running inside of a virtual machine. And as you can see, it's running Windows 11 Enterprise on the latest version. So this works great. This is right now the best option for you to get Windows 11 is going to be, or getting Windows Enterprise is going to be using the command that I showed you here in Command Prompt. Until the creator of this tool updates this, like I said, this is a great tool, but until this guy updates this so it's working again, if you want to get the full-fledged version, you'll have to run that tool. Otherwise, if you just want to test drive it and see if you'd even be interested in using Enterprise, you can just download one of these ISOs right here. Anyway, this is going to wrap the video up. If you like it, make sure to go and drop a like. Let me know if you hate it. Be a seagull. Go shit up the comments. I don't really care. With all that being said, I'll see you in the next video.